morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. God has awakened us to another bright new day with all its opportunities for pleasing Him. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Alleluia, alleluia.
Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the
prayer on this Thursday morning begins on page 34 of our Books of Common Prayer with the opening sentence for Easter, and then on to page 35 and following. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. We continue in prayer. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Jubilate. Oh, shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good. His love and mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. Now we are in God's presence this morning, acknowledging that we have fallen short of God's expectations of us, that we are in need of God's forgiveness. And so let us together confess our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now we continue with the psalm, and the psalm appointed this morning is, we will use the psalm 71, beginning on page 556. Let us recite the psalm together. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed. In your righteousness, deliver me and set me free. Incline your ear to me and save me. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. You are my crag and my stronghold. Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evildoer and the oppressor. For you are my hope, O Lord God, my confidence since I was young. I've been sustained by you ever since I was born. From my mother's womb, you've been my strength. My praise shall be always of you. I've become a portent to many, but you are my refuge and my strength. Let my mouth be full of your praise and your glory all the day long. Do not cast me off in my old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails. For my enemies are talking against me, and those who lie in wait for my life take counsel together. They say, God has forsaken him. Go after him and seize him, because there is none who will save. O God, be not far from me. Come quickly to help me, O my God. Let those who set themselves against me be put to shame and be disgraced. Let those who seek to do me evil be covered with scorn and reproach. But I shall always wait in patience and shall praise you more and more. My mouth shall recount your mighty acts and saving deeds all day long. Though I cannot know the number of them, I will begin with the mighty works of the Lord God. I will recall your righteousness, yours alone. O God, you have taught me since I was young, and to this day I tell of your wonderful works. And now that I am old and gray-headed, O God, do not forsake me till I make known your strength to this generation and your power to all who are to come. Your righteousness, O God, reaches to the heavens. You have done great things. Who is like you, O God? You have showed me great troubles and adversities, but you will restore my life and bring me up again from the deep places of the earth. You strengthen me more and more. You enfold and comfort me. Therefore, I will praise you upon the lyre for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing to you with a harp, O Holy One of Israel. My lips will sing with joy when I pray to you, and so will my soul, which you have redeemed. My tongue will proclaim your righteousness all day long, for they are ashamed and disgraced who sought to do me harm. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And now we have the first reading, and our first reading is taken from the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, and we're reading from verses 26 to 37. You shall not eat anything with its blood. You shall not practice augury or witchcraft. You shall not round off the hair on your temples or mar the edges of your beard. You shall not make any gashes in your flesh for the dead or tattoo any marks upon you. I am the Lord. Do not profane your daughter by making her a prostitute, so that the land may not become prostituted and full of depravity. You shall keep my Sabbaths and reverence my sanctuary. I am the Lord. Do not turn to mediums or wizards. Do not seek them out to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God. You shall rise before the aged and defer to the old, and you shall fear your God. I am the Lord. When an alien resides with you in your land, you shall not oppress the alien. The alien who resides with you shall be to you as the citizen among you. You shall love the alien as yourself, for you were aliens in the land of Egypt. I am the Lord your God. You shall not cheat in measuring length, width, or quantity. You shall have honest balances, honest weights, an honest ephah, and an honest hin. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt. You shall keep all my statutes and all my ordinances and observe them. I am the Lord. This is the end of the reading. Thanks be to God. And we continue with our canticle, which we will find on page 52, Jesus, Savior. Jesus, Savior of the world, come to us in your mercy. We look to you to save and help us. By your cross and your life laid down, you set your people free. We look to you to save and help us. When they were ready to perish, you saved your disciples. We look to you to come to our help. In the greatness of your mercy, loose us from our chains. Forgive the sins of all your people. Make yourself known as our Savior and mighty Deliverer. Save and help us that we may praise you. Come now and dwell with us, Lord Christ Jesus. Hear our prayer and be with us always. And when you come in your glory, make us to be one with you and to share the life of your kingdom. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And we will now have our second reading from Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 to 34. Matthew 6, 25 to 34. Jesus continued, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, 'What will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear?' For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today." This is the end of the reading. Thanks be to God.
Ask and it shall be.
Let us now reflect on this passage that we read from Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 to 34. And it will be worth our, as we reflect on this passage, it will be worth our while to go back as well to verse 24, the verse just before we started today's reading. May God be with us to inspire our reflection on this passage. So the verse 24 sort of, in a sense, puts it all together. Jesus is saying, no one can serve two masters. For a slave will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and wealth. Some translations say God and mammon. And we can put it another way. We can say we can't serve both God and the things of this world. We can't, you know, there's a real dichotomy. If we pursue the things of this world, if that is our exclusive desire to acquire the things of this world that our eyes can see, our senses can experience, that we can enjoy for while we have life here on earth, if we pursue these things exclusively, we will automatically find that we'll lose out on what is most important for us, because we won't be serving God. And we lose out on what God has in store for all of us. And so Jesus is now, in this passage that we read today, is explaining that we have needs. Material needs as human beings, and God knows these needs that we have. We have material needs, we have sensual needs, we have, you know, emotional needs. We have all kinds of needs. God knows the needs that we have. And God is on our side. As we bring the needs that we have before God, legitimate needs before God, then God will make it possible for us to attain to those things that are needed. And Jesus makes reference to, you know, the birds of the air, the lilies of the field. You know, when we look at them, we ask the question, who is looking after them? You know, who is looking after the birds and supplying them, enabling them to meet the needs that they have? And even the lilies of the field, so well decked off. You know, where does this come from? We have to learn from that. As God looks after his natural creation, so God looks after his human creation, so much more. And so we shouldn't go overboard. Jesus says, we bring our needs to God. God will show us the way that we will be able, you know, to meet these needs in a way that will be pleasing to him, that will glorify him, in a way that will not bring harm to others or hurt to others, in a way that will help us to meet our needs and even help us to help others to meet their needs. This is the way that God will work. But if we get too carried away with acquiring this material and tasting the sensual, and, you know, trying to experience and acquire, you know, these attractive things in this world, if that's our pursuit, if we go overboard in the pursuit of these things, if that's all that is in our way, then we will find we cannot serve both God and mammon. We will find ourselves, you know, not being able to really serve God. All of our time and energy and thoughts, indeed our very lives and therefore our worship, what is most on our minds, what we are most concerned about, we'll be putting all our time and effort and energy, you know, into acquiring those the earthly things, the things that really are attractive but are transient. We'll be misplacing, you know, our trust and our hope, and God will be left behind, and we will lose out and what God has in store for each and every one of us. God has a place, which Jesus speaks about in many places in the gospel. God has a place for us. Those who are faithful, those who are concerned about doing what is pleasing to God. Even as we seek to meet our needs, we seek through God, we look to God to help us to supply our needs. And we will then give God what is his due of honor and glory. We wouldn't on our own seek to get all those things that we want and leaving God aside. So it is very important for us to understand that we can gain the whole world, as Jesus said. All those things in the world that we so want, you know, fame, you know, status, you know, material possessions, all the, you know, attractions of the world that we are able to participate in. You know. Yes, all of that we might have in this life. We might gain the whole world. The whole world, but as Jesus says, we will lose our souls. We will lose the very life that God really made each of us for. God made us all for himself, that we might so live here, you know, in obedience to his way, in giving him the honor and the glory, you know. So walking with him, you know, on this earthly journey, you know, that we will attain to what he has in store for us, that gift of eternal life. So we would have, by pursuing the things of this world, we would have very short-sightedly, we would have gained the whole world. And that would be the end of it. It would be our very destruction. And we would lose that eternal life, that gift God, of eternal life in God's presence. We would have lost what was the very, you know, essence, the very reason that God made us for life with him. And Jesus is just making this point that we shouldn't be so distracted by the things of this world. Put all our effort and time, even worry and all, you know, our talent into acquiring the things of this world. You know, don't remember when we are in need that God will supply us. Have that faith that God will supply us with our needs. We don't have to sell our souls in order to get the things that our Heavenly Father knows that we would need. We, in faith, bring them before God, and God in his way and in his time will ensure that our needs are met. So Jesus is saying we can't serve but God and Mammon. And may we have that wisdom, you know, that understanding, and may, you know, by God's grace, may we be able, you know, at every stage to distinguish when we are going overboard, when we are going on that path of worshipping the things of this world, so desiring them, so zealously and jealously desiring them, that we are turning our backs on God and God's grace and love and God's desire to, you know, to give us what we really need. May we have the wisdom to discern when we are going down that wrong road. In other words, may we be able to repent and turn back so that God can lead us in the way that leads to him and to eternal life. Jesus makes it very clear that the most important thing for us in this life is the kingdom of God. It's the most important thing. May we always make those choices for God, first of all, rather than for the things of the world, rather than for mammon. Maybe by God's grace have that strength and courage, you know, that discernment that help us to make the right choices. That when we are going on the wrong path, that by God's grace, our eyes will be opened and we will turn around, repent, and return to that path that God wants us to go, that path that leads to Him. And may we remember always, the most important thing in this life is that we live in such a way that we are on that road, making those choices at every stage, so we are on the road that leads to eternal life. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all the other things in this world will fall into place in the right way. Always giving God the honor and the glory. The Lord be with you. We continue with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We continue with the prayers that our Savior has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now we have our collect. The collect for today. And we find our collect on page 170 of our Books of Common Prayer, the collect for the fifth Sunday of Easter. Let us pray. Almighty God, whom truly to know is everlasting life, grant us so perfectly to know your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the way, the truth, and the life, that we may steadfastly follow his steps in the way that leads to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We continue in prayer. O God, our Father, you've bidden light to shine out of darkness, and have awakened us again to praise your goodness and to seek your grace. Make us children of the light and of the day, that our lives be open to your glory, we may shine as lights in the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we continue to pray. And we pray for God's world, for people in every part of this world where there is strife and fighting and death and oppression, and where there is even famine and starving and where people are undergoing, owing to man's inhumanity to man, all kinds of pain and suffering. We highlight places like the Ukraine, where there is war, Yemen, parts of Sudan, even in Syria, in places where people are experiencing oppressive governments, Sri Lanka, where there is collapse of the whole financial system. In all those places where people are suffering, Lord, we pray your intervention. We pray for your help. We pray for the leaders, that you touch hearts and minds and give them hearts, Lord, that will seek peace, that will seek solution to the problems of the ordinary people who are suffering. In our own Anglican communion, we pray for the Most Reverend Justin Welby, Archbishop of Canterbury. In our own church in the province of the West Indies, we pray for the Most Reverend Howard Gregory, who is Archbishop of our province and also Bishop of Jamaica. We lift up all the bishops in our various dioceses in this province, and we pray your hand upon them of blessed inspiration, of love, Lord. We pray especially for our own Bishop Claude. Lord, we thank you for sustaining him through these times of trial that he has been going through. We pray for healing for his wife. We pray for faith and courage and that Christian hope, Lord, as he is coming to terms with the loss of his own mother. We pray for all our retired priests, those especially those who are sick and need to be cared for. May your hand of blessing and peace be upon them. In all our parishes, in our diocese, we pray for the clergy. Inspire us, Lord, as we seek to lead your people in all the communities in which we serve, to be true representatives, to be true shepherds, that through the work that we do, others will come to know about the Good Shepherd and really, you know, come to find satisfaction in their lives. Today we pray for our country and for our leaders that you have put in authority over us. Inspire the decision making, Lord, so that the decisions that are made will always be in the best interest of all. We pray for our people. Give us a sense of togetherness, a sense that you've put us together in this place, Lord, to work together to make this country of ours one that will be a shining example to others. May we truly understand that we are all our brothers and sisters keepers. We pray for all those who are in need of any kind today, that they experience your very presence and your help and strength and courage and hope in their time of challenge at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We turn to the prayer of dedication on page 47. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.